We met back in 1999, we were both in college, actually both had Volkswagen Beetles. I was driving down the road one day and saw this girl driving a Volkswagen. I saw her at school in the computer lab and I was like, well, I've gotta go talk to this chick that has this Volkswagen. Fell in love and were married pretty quickly after that.
I had emailed my mom and was like, check this out, he's the one. Before we started thinking that we wanted to build a family and have a baby, we traveled.
Enjoyed life, really. We were the rock and roll uncle and aunt. For me, it was this day I was driving home and I just looked over and saw this kind of grandpa with his granddaughter walking in our neighborhood near this school. And I just kind of had this weird moment where I was just like, if we don't have kids, like, who are we gonna be? What are we gonna be doing?
I wanted those experiences and we weren't gonna have them if we didn't have kids. We decided we wanted to start trying, so I went to my doctor. I needed thyroid medication, and it's when she kind of started to uncover some stuff. I started to seek medical help when we were trying to build our family. We had been trying actively for about a year, year and a half, and I'd been working with my doctor on some other medications, and it just wasn't working. And at that point, when my OB ran some labs, that's when she told me that according to my blood work, it didn't look like I was ovulating. At that point going forward, we knew that we were gonna need some sort of medical intervention. We just weren't 100% sure yet what it would be. I first started out taking Clomid. I did several rounds of Clomid. Once I moved on from Clomid, we were then with a reproductive endocrinologist, and that was where I did letrozole with trigger shots. We moved on from there actually straight to IVF. At that point, we took a break. After that break, we began treatment with Dr. Chantillis, and that was what led us to the egg donor program. The first time using an egg donor was mentioned to us was at the previous clinic that we had been at when we were struggling with getting my body to respond to some of the medications we were taking. And we realized at that point that my egg reserve was low, and our doctor just kind of mentioned, hey, egg donor is an option. And it kind of shot my wheels off a little bit. It was the first I'd heard of it personally, and that was an absolute no, because that didn't seem like something at that point that would be something that could work for us as a family. I kind of wrote it off as an option for us because it just seemed really kind of alien to me. It didn't feel normal at that point. That didn't feel like our family was supposed to be us. So it didn't involve another person. After I did some research and some reading, egg donation was something that would work for us. The traditional way of us building a family wasn't going to work. If we were going to have a baby that wasn't going to share my DNA and my genetics, I think he's pretty cool. And so I really thought, you know what, I'm okay with this now, because at least we can have a baby that involves him and shares part of, I love so many things about him.
Things that we did when we were going through this, we are both very different in the way that we process information and how we react and stuff like that. And so I'm very much a social person and, you know, a lot of times feel that need to connect with other people. For her, it was a little more, circle the wagons, don't really tell anybody.
When we started the process of choosing our egg donor, I was given the information from the clinic here at Dr. Chantillis' office, and I started to look through the database of options that we have. And really, I kind of did that on my own. I tend to obsess over details, and he's more of a big picture guy. I looked through the database and just kind of went through until I feel like I did find the perfect person. Some of the things that I felt were important when we searched for an egg donor, I love my blue eyes. That was something that I was sad that we would miss out on when we had a baby, was they wouldn't get my big blue eyes. Really, it's going to be individual, and the way I feel is absolutely not going to be the way the next person will feel, because we all approach this so differently anyway. So we had 7 embryos. I went through 4 different IVF transfers myself with those. One was a chemical pregnancy. We did have a miscarriage too at 8 weeks. And then Dr. Chantillis, when I got to my last 2 embryos, Dr. Chantillis had mentioned a gestational carrier being an option for us. I had put a post on Facebook, and when I put this post up about our struggle with infertility, a family member actually approached us and she asked if she could carry a baby for us. And then that's how we ended up with our gestational carrier to kind of finish out this story for us. I feel like her egg donor is she's a very special person. Obviously what she did was huge, and to be able to provide us the opportunity to be parents as well. I think it finally hit me that I was gonna be a mom. It was pretty far into the process. We had been through just a lot of losses and letdowns, and so I kept my guard up for a really long time as he painted the nursery pink. And, you know, as we just started to bring her things into the house, I think that was really when, you know, it kind of started to sink in. It doesn't really occur to me much that Juliet's not genetically my child, that she's not from my egg. Every now and then she'll do something quirky that she gets from me, and that's where it will kind of be like, hey, like, you got that from me. Of course, DFW Fertility Associates was great for us. It was a great switch that we made. Dr. Chantillis was exactly the answer that we needed. He had the answers that we needed. He listened to us. He helped us through that process. And honestly, he helped us in ways that we had no idea we could be helped at that particular point.
It was a relief because it was nice to have a little bit bigger of a support system. Now we had people that were interested and that were asking those questions of, hey, how's it going? Did everything, you know, they're very interested.
So definitely reach out to Dr. Chantillis and the staff at DFW Fertility Associates and let them help you through this.